Hi, good morning everyone. Dr. Tam and Lakeisha here, and today I'd like to answer a lot of questions that a lot of people have asked her and I both regarding salads. You know, what's a good salad? What's a bad one? So, you know, what's the first thing people ask about salads, Keisha?
So the first question I typically get is dressing. What are bad dressings and what are good dressings for salads?
Okay, well that's a great question because many people think that when they think about salad dressing, they're looking at the ranch, they're looking at the Caesar, they're looking at the Thousand Island. And those are all the really thick ranches or the thick dressings that you just cannot have in a salad because they're filled with sugars, binders, fillers. They're just full of junk, right? And even some of the natural ones are full of dairy as well. So you have to stay away from that. See, what you should stick with is gonna be your good olive oil, right?
Okay.
Now, a lot of olive oil, sometimes when you buy it in the store, they're infused with vegetable oil. So you gotta really watch out for those things. But olive oil that's infused in garlic is good as well. Balsamic vinaigrette. Those are some good fats. They're not sweet. So you gotta get the ones that are unsweetened because some balsamic vinaigrette are just loaded with sugar. And you can't have that because that's gonna spike your insulin. And we wanna be healthy and lose weight, you gotta keep insulin down, okay?
Perfect. The second I usually get that's very, very big is good fats versus bad fats in your salad.
Okay, so some of the good fats, let's talk about the good ones first.
Okay.
It's gonna be your avocados, pecans, nuts, but depending on what nuts, because there should be walnuts. Okay, it's gotta be walnuts. Your almond is actually higher in sugar and not as good in fat.
Okay.
So you gotta stick with the good fat ones. Having olive oil is good fat, right? Okay. Having eggs in there is a good fat as well. You know, and good bacon, but maybe like one strip or half a strip. Don't do like 4, 5, 6 strips in there. But what does good bacon mean? It's gotta be the ones that are non-nitrate, non-GMO'd, they're not genetically modified, which means that it's gotta be healthy bacon. And usually it's the ones not out of a package, okay, but the ones from the deli. And some of the oils that people talk to me about, like what, corn oil, vegetable oil, you gotta stay away from that. So those are all of your bad fats, and even cheese. A lot of people like cheese, and you think like, oh, I'm gonna add cheese and protein or calcium. It's actually bad for you because it spikes your insulin, and cheese has a lot of hormones and antibiotics in them, antibiotics that you just don't want. Right.
Yeah, makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
The next one I get is vegetables and leafy greens.
Okay.
What is the best type of leafy green to make your salad with, and what vegetables should I add and shouldn't I add in my salad?
Okay, so let's talk about the ones you should not have.
Okay.
Right? You shouldn't have corn.
Okay.
You should not have, you know, a lot of people think that iceberg lettuce, when they see a salad, that iceberg lettuce could be good. And that's what sometimes they make salads with, right?
Yes.
When you buy at the store. But you gotta make these salads at home because iceberg salad has no nutritional value, almost zero. It's just like water, okay? Whereas romaine lettuce has a lot more nutrition. Make it with your green and leafy, but it's gotta be organic though.
Okay.
Because the non-organic ones has a lot of pesticides, and that will cause more harm than good. You see, that will kind of really throw off your stomach.
Okay.
But it's gonna be your kale, your romaine lettuce, spinach, your greens, collard greens, mustard greens, and you can even throw in beets in there, right? But say corn. Corn's another one to stay away from, and soy products as well. That's gonna throw off your whole fat burning capabilities.
Okay, mm-hmm. All right. How about croutons and fruit?
Oh.
I love croutons and fruit.
Yeah, because people are gonna put in that card.
Yes.
When your body is toxic, right? You're gonna want more, you know, sugar cravings.
Yes.
You're gonna want more toxic food. So croutons, wonton strips, fruits are all very, very desirable to put in because it's sweet. But what happens when you put in those fruits and croutons and, you know, all the wonton strips is that it spikes your insulin.
Okay.
And now instead of burning fat, which is what the salad's supposed to be, you're eating it to burn more fat and be healthier, you're actually storing fat, you know, quite the opposite. So I would stay away from all the fruits, croutons. I know it comes with those little packages, but you gotta toss them. Okay. Yeah, you gotta throw those away. I know.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Mm-hmm. The last I usually get is beans. Can I add beans in my salad?
Yeah, so beans, I mean, unless if you're a vegetarian, then maybe the garbanzo beans are going to be okay.
Okay.
Because you can't have any other protein, right?
Correct.
But really, you want to stay away from all the legumes and beans and grains in general.
Okay.
You know, you want to stay away from that as much as possible because beans is a very starchy carb, and even though it's a vegetable, but it's very starchy, so you want to stay away from that. But some of the other good proteins that you can put in there is, it's got to be your, you know, wild-caught fish,
okay,
right? Wild-caught sardines, wild-caught salmon, wild-caught tuna, your beef that is grass-fed, lamb, chicken that's pasture-raised, eggs. These are all really, really good proteins that you have to stick with and stay away from the beans,
okay,
as much as possible because your body doesn't need it, right?
Perfect. Makes sense.
Makes sense, right?
Absolutely.
So hopefully after listening to this, a lot of you are going to know and realize how to make a really healthy salad. And in the link below the video, we're going to include some healthy salads, a few choices that you can click on. That's going to include a lot of the, you know, ingredients that I talk about. And that way, number one, you're going to be healthier. You're going to be burning more fat, lowering insulin, and live a longer and fulfilled life. So until next time, Dr. Ham, Lakeisha here. We'll do a next video and help you learn a lot more. Have a great day.